rat associations. Filth, dirt, vermin, disease, poverty, race, discrimination, garbage, tenements, low-income housing, urban. The abject, disgust, in parentheses vermin, versus desire, luxury, and fur. Breeding, alleys, no control, wanton, sex. Breeding for laboratory science, albino rats. Furtive, teeming, opportunistic, greedy, corrupt, colonizers, us. My name is Janice Wright Cheney, and I'm from Fredericton, New Brunswick. My exhibition, Cellar, is about our relationship with rats. That's to me a very complicated relationship, and that's exactly why I'm interested in it. But overall, I guess I'm exploring rats as they exist in the world as vermin, which means they're undesirable and dirty and something to be controlled and avoided. To me, rats signify our excess. They thrive where we thrive, and they live off of our waste. I've come to realize through working with the rats and the reading that I've done and the conversations that I've had and responses that I've had to the work that they represent our excess in a way that is unpleasant to us to witness. And I think that's part of the reason why we hate them. As the viewer enters the room, there isn't a lot of space to approach the cages and the rats. And so I understand, I've even noticed today how some people are hesitant, or there's a bit of a pause. That is actually what I want them to do. The reaction is in the body to these life-size creatures that are too numerous to count, and you can't even get a full sense of how many there are in the room. Even while you're in there, there's some in the shadows. There's a sense of maybe they might even move. Some people might experience a little bit of that. So for sure, I'm trying to play with creating a sense of discomfort for the viewer. And then I'm asking questions about why that is so. I'm interested in animals who are perceived to transgress those borders that humans impose, and the conflicts and the situations that arise from that. The material is really important because it's animal, and so I'm using an animal to make animals. The furs are muskrat, mink, beaver, seal, Persian lamb. I even have a squirrel coat cut up in there. So some of these animals are even rodents, which is interesting. These creatures that became coats are valued differently. They're valued for their fur, and their fur is seen as being luxurious and desirable and associated with wealth and prestige, luxury. So for me, it makes a little bit of a conflict or a tension to use that material and then make an animal out of it that is so loathed and so undesirable. So that's an interesting juxtaposition. And as I was making the coats, it also occurred to me that it was kind of reversing the process, because the animals are skinned and the pelts are treated and then the coats are constructed. But then I was undoing that process by kind of skinning the coat, taking the lining out and turning it back into the raw fur, if you will, and then turning it back into an animal. So that was an interesting idea to me, that I was sort of playing with the life of that fur. When I was planning the installation, I realized that it would be good if the rats had an environment to make some suggestions for the viewer. So these cages, I call them cages, but they're really more like sort of wire display units, are useful because they stack in such a way that we can sort of experience the rats at different heights in the room and sort of see through them to see more rats. But I also thought they set up associations that could be helpful, and it's open-ended. The viewer may even bring some associations that are their own, but I was of course thinking about such things as fur farming and laboratories, and trying to suggest, you know, what what happened here, because the rats are no longer being completely contained by the cages. Some of them are inside the cages and some of them are out. And that also speaks to this greater idea, I suppose, of how it's hard to contain or control rats. In my work, I'm really not trying to answer any questions, but really just ask questions and invite conversations and dialogue about these things. There's a really lovely quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson that I'd like to read to you. He writes, "Evermore in the world is this marvelous balance of beauty and disgust, magnificence and rats." And I'll add to that with Leanne McTavish, one of the curators of the exhibition, wrote in response to that quote that according to Emerson, every part of nature is worthy of study, even rats, and we cannot really know about the environment or ourselves without engaging with such creatures. And I like that because it's like it speaks of a kind of a complete experience, and that's what I would like to offer.